Hey guys, we're out here at Simmons Park today. This is my first time back at anything saltwater since the red tide hit here in Tampa. I got one line out with a shrimp on it. There's a bunch of stuff jumping around here, so I figured I'd give the cast net a try. Let's see if I can turn you around over here. And I see I got my one line over there, just in case something bites it. I don't know if y'all heard that, but a fish just jumped a few feet away from the dock. I think they're a tiny mullet, but after my terrible stint of freshwater fishing, not being able to saltwater fish for like a month, I'll take any kind of fish at this point, just to say I caught fish. Alright, I think we're gonna just go ahead and throw it, because I see them jumping everywhere, so we'll see what happens. I saw at least one in this net while I was pulling it in. So I wonder, either it was too small, or is there a hole somewhere in this net? I don't see a hole nowhere, so I'm just assuming the mullet were just too small to swim through the mesh. But there was definitely one or two in it when it was first laying on the ground. You know, where there's little ones, hopefully there's big ones too. Wait till we see a good jump again and then we'll throw. I'll talk really quick. The particular cast netting technique I'm using, I learned from a old guy at the Oldsmar Pier a couple weeks back. I grew up fishing, throwing it, you know, putting the line in my mouth, but especially now with the red tide, who wants to do that? So he he taught me a trick. It's basically the exact same makeup. It's just throw it over your shoulder instead of put it in your mouth. Fish. Don't tell me I'm gonna get one cast and then never come back again. Sometimes I won't even wait for fish just because holding the net can be a pain. I just throw it at random, but I usually don't get anything when I do that. Nice to see something start pulling on my fishing pole over there. Give me an excuse to drop the net. Some giant mosquito continually buzzing my head, bothering the hell out of me. But I don't want to put the net down for that. There's nothing worse than just dropping your cast net. At least throwing it, even if you don't get fish, is fun. Something to throw at again. Come on, guys. I heard something. Not close by, though. You always see a mysterious ripple in the water, and you wonder, could that be a school of fish? Just none of them are jumping, so you don't know. Don't want to risk throwing the net, that kind of thing. The tide right now is still going out at the very end of the on the way down to low tide. I think low tide was around 6:30. Right now it's about 5:15, 5:20-ish. Fuck. a little flash in the water. Oyster shell, that's always a plus. See if I got a shrimp left. Hope nothing stole my bait and never hit the line. Yeah, still got a shrimp. This is a drop shot configuration, typically used on freshwater, but I'm gonna try it because it's already on the rig, so. Hoping if I do get a decent fish on there, it won't break it off, because right now it's still set up for freshwater with a 30-pound braid, which that's my saltwater setup, and then an 8-pound fluorocarbon leader. Something for freshwater fish, so the bass can't see it. Good saltwater fish could break that off. This is gonna. After my non-existent ability to get a bass or any kind of freshwater fish, even if it broke the line up, just fighting a fish of any kind at this point would be fun. Something was kicking up sand there. But nothing jumping and no little flashes in the water. The only real bad thing about this particular setup of throwing the net is you can't really lean down on anything or it'll just fall off your shoulder. Have to build one of these clothespin little contraptions that you wear, and that'll hold the line for you. if we don't get fish. It's nice and calming out here. Listen to the water rippling against the bank over there. Might be able to see him. There's a ripple out there. Hoping he comes up while the camera's pointing at him. That sounded like somebody in the distance threw a cast net too. Maybe off a little beach that's over there to the left. Kind of breezy out here, just watching my braided line over there, wondering if it's a fish or the wind pulling my line one direction or the other. something to throw at. I'm kind of tired of holding this net now. Just know, as soon as I put the net down, the school of fish will come by. Manatee get out there saying hi. Maybe I'll start this again if I see some fish. Oh, there was that manatee. Right nearby, too. I think the camera caught those ripples out there. Maybe he can scare up some mullet for me. Of course, they're both plant eaters, right? I think manatees eat plants. I don't think they eat other fish. Herbivores, that's what they are. I feel like they lowered the dock since the last time I was here. The railing, anyway. where I used to be able to lean right here on it, and now it's like a foot below me. Not looking that direction. See, there he is. Yeah, that was kind of on camera. Just stuck his nose out of the water.
Hopefully you saw that.
Hey buddy, why don't you go find some mullet and bring it over here for me? It's definitely starting to get a little crampy. Oh, just give me something to throw it. I think it's three manatees. Oh shit. fish on here. Fish. Well, the drop shot with the shrimp worked. Not exactly the right kind of fish I wanted to catch, but he's not a bad size, but I'm not really into keeping catfish. I might keep him. We'll see. Let me get some water in the bucket. I hear you, fish. Chill out over there. The catfish are slimy as hell. So, regardless of what anybody says, I'm going to put gloves on. Plus, you get a better grip on the fish. There's my little catfish. He's about 10, 12 inches long. We might keep him, we'll see. Guess I need another shrimp. So while I was taking a quick break from filming, I just got another catfish. It has the shrimp still sticking in its mouth with the hook. And it's actually bigger than the last one. So we could definitely say the catfish are biting. That's kind of standard here though. Alright, let me dispatch with this. Okay. Now that all the catfish fun is over. Apparently if I want one of them, I got no problems. But let's see if I can get something else. Up onto the dock, looked around, and then crawled back into the mangrove. He's sitting down here, watching me, looking to see if I got fish. Probably smells the catfish or the shrimp in the bucket. Go away. Have you for dinner. Raccoon is very good, I've heard. Something, I think. Oh yeah, there's something in the net. Oh, I saw a little flash. Oh wow, no, he took out of the net. Something in there. Really second guessing, is there a hole in this damn thing that they keep finding? Or am I just catching fish too small? Yeah, I think there is a couple mesh squares that have torn loose. Big enough that a small to medium-sized fish will find their way out. Look at this guy. He's so curious that I got fish. Shoo! I got no fish for you. Go! Scurried off and then he came right back. I know, you smelled catfish. For a little raccoon friend to come back. Raccoon are smart. He'd probably take the fish right out of the bucket. So I didn't catch any fish, but I did catch somebody's pair of sunglasses. It's now an artificial reef full of oyster shells and shit. I think we'll throw those away, because you know, you should always leave it better than you found it. that shrimp was. Watch while I'm holding the fishing pole. Let's school them a little swim by. Fish on my line. Yeah, my line is straight. Oh, yep, fish on. Fish on. Probably another catfish. Too small for even an appetizer.
swallowed that hook good.
Left of the shrimp. Maybe the tide shift is happening right now because all of a sudden the water like stopped moving. You know, it's been crashing against this beach over here pretty well and all of a sudden now dead silent. So maybe we're right between high and low now. 7:03. I guess at some point here a ranger might come and tell me to leave. Park officially closes at 7. If you're camping here, you get 24-hour access to it. So every now and then they kind of think you're a camper. But we'll see. Want to just get one more throw. It's also possible it's just now 7 o'clock, so they're making their rounds and they're not here because I'm at the very back of the park. White truck. Is it after 7?
Yes, sir.
All right, I'll pack up.
Have a good one.
Thanks, man. I might as well throw just once more, right? Good opening. One more time, cleaning that now. All right, guys, well, that does it for Simmons Park. Hope you guys enjoyed watching me catch a little bit of catfish. We may do some cooking clean later, but as always, like and subscribe, and I'll catch you next time.